In the previous video, you would have learnt about states of matter and how particles are arranged and behave in a solid, liquid, and a gas. In this video, we're going to look at how states of matter change from one state to another. When we add heat to any substance, the kinetic energy of the particles are increased. This causes them to move around more and at an increased speed. If we add enough heat to a solid, the particles will begin to move around so much that they will no longer be in a fixed position or held in a fixed shape. At this point, the substance becomes a liquid. The process of changing from a solid to a liquid is called melting. If we add enough heat to a liquid, the particles move around so much that the substance will become less and less dense. If we keep heating the particles, they will eventually rise up out of the liquid and have enough kinetic energy to move freely. At this point, the substance becomes a gas. The process of changing from a liquid to a gas is called evaporation. There are special circumstances where when heat is added to a solid, it skips the melting phase and immediately transforms into a gas. This is called sublimation. An example of this is dry ice. When we remove heat from any substance, the kinetic energy of the particles is decreased. When we remove heat from a gas, the particles start to slow down. This causes them to move closer together, and therefore the gas becomes more dense. As more heat is removed, the particles slow down even further, and they condense into a liquid state. We see examples of this when gas particles in the form of steam from a hot shower touch the cold glass of the shower door and condense back into a liquid. This process is called condensation. When heat is removed from a liquid, the particles slow down so much that the movements become mere vibrations. The particles are unable to roll around each other and so become fixed in a position and therefore a fixed shape. This is the point at which a liquid transforms into a solid. This is called freezing or solidification. The opposite of sublimation is called deposition. This is where a gas turns into a solid without first turning into a liquid. We see examples of this with snowflakes forming straight from water vapor. When summarizing the changes in state of matter, I'd love to look at a diagram like this one. It represents these changes clearly and shows whether we're adding or removing heat in order for those changes to occur. And this sort of a diagram would be very good to put into your summary notes or your revision notes if you need this for an exam. If you like this video, please hit like below and please subscribe for more videos from me. Thank you.